Good morning. Here is today's word of blessings for you. Song of Songs 7:1-5. How beautiful your sandaled feet, O prince's daughter! Your graceful legs are like jewels, the work of an artist's hands. Your navel is a rounded goblet that never lacks blended wine. Your waist is a mound of wheat encircled by lilies. Your breasts are like two fawns, like twin fawns of a gazelle. Your neck is like an ivory tower. Your eyes are the pools of Heshbon by the gate of Bath Rabbim. Your nose is like the tower of Lebanon looking toward Damascus. Your head crowns you like Mount Carmel. Your hair is like royal tapestry, the king is held captive by its tresses. Today's title is beautiful from head to toe. One of the most frightening experiences for many people is to be surveyed by others. Not many people have confidence in themselves, so they don't mind getting the attention of the crowd, except those who aspire for popularity, the people such as entertainers and professional politicians. Most of us feel uncomfortable when we are watched closely by other people. We often feel scared and intimidated. Why do we feel so? I think we feel so because we all have some inferiority complex hidden inside of us. We all have things that we don't want to disclose to others. The only people we disclose ourselves completely are those whom we can trust completely, such as parents or spouses. We could have something that we don't want to disclose even to these intimate people. But how about God? It could be the most frightening thing to stand before God, who see through us, including all the ugly parts of our life. We all love to go to heaven. But if we have gone through such a thorough examination of all-seeing God, heaven could be as frightening as hell. That's why we need the Lamb of God not only on earth but in heaven. To our greatest relief, the Lamb of God who died and washed away our sins and made us dress in his righteousness will be right next to God in heaven. God's penetrating eyes will be scanning through us from head to toe. We might all be freezing with fear. But God turns his face toward us and will say pretty much like what's said by the divine bridegroom in today's passage. The groom praises every part of the body of the bride. From the sandaled feet to the crowned head, there is no part of the bride's body that isn't beautiful and attractive. I believe this is how God views the church as the bride of Christ. The church is not always considered so beautiful in the eyes of the world. We tend to find the ugly part of it more easily than the beauty. But God views it so positively, for it is indeed the body of Christ, the Lamb of God. It is washed completely by the blood of the Lamb. It is dressed in his righteousness. How do you see the church? In God's way or in man's way?